Today we are going to revise the chapter from the diary of Anne Frank. Okay, so you know Anne Frank is a young girl who at the age of 13 years has written her diary. As she has suffered the persecutions during World War II. Okay, so during that time what has happened that the Jewish people, they have met number of, you can say, problems. They suffered a lot. They have faced number of atrocities in human behavior, and because of this reason they were forced to live in hiding. So Anne's family, they lived in hiding in one of the, you can say, office friend of his father. And ultimately what happened when they were living in hiding, she has started writing a diary when she was at the age of 13 years. And during that time she has recorded all the incidents that has happened in her life, the days, important days, how they have celebrated, how she felt there. And ultimately after one of the person who cheated the family and informed the police that there is a family living in hiding along with one other family. So the police took them away in the concentration camps, where because of poor condition what happened, she died of typhus. And her diary was recovered by her father after that. And ultimately it was advised to his father that the diary should be published. Okay, that the diary should be published. And later on what has happened, that this, you can say, that this diary, it has turned out to be a greatest, greatest witness of the type of life people spent during World War II, how they have felt during that time. Okay, so it is because of this reason. One minute, please. So it is because of this reason that the diary was given a complete account of the different type of people who have suffered Holocaust. Okay, what is Holocaust? While the chapter was being read, I told you that Holocaust means the type of treatment met by, you can say, number of people at one time. Okay, they are died because of racial discrimination or the different kinds of different types of discrimination. Okay, so number of people were killed in human behavior without any reason. Okay, so this is the greatest example of Holocaust, and ultimately she has given a complete and clear account of what has happened during World War II. Okay, so now as I told you that this is just a chapter which has been taken from the famous novel The Diary of a Young Girl. Okay, there all the chapters, they are in the form of diary entries. Okay, so these diary entries, they have been, you can say, written, giving an account today, how the day was, what we have done, how we have spent the day. So it was very difficult for them to live in hiding. It means that they were not able to talk louder. They were not at night, you can say, talk or celebrate, switch on the light also. And moreover, you will imagine that how difficult it was for them to live in such type of condition. Okay, because the people must not come to know that there is another family living there. Okay, so it is because of this reason this family has suffered a lot, and finally her father was the only survivor of the family after that, when they were drawn or they were dragged to concentration camps. So how did Anne died of? She died of typhus fever. So in the family, who are there in Anne's family? Her father, mother, as well as her sister Margot. Okay, she is 3 years elder to her. Okay, so when she has started writing, so she has mentioned in the starting that one day she was feeling very depressed. Okay, so first of all, she has also mentioned about the concept of writing a diary. She thought that it is she is not at all interested in writing a diary. Why she was not interested in writing a diary? Because she thought that anyone would be interested in the musings of a 13-year-old girl. It means that nobody would be interested in the thinking of this 13-year-old girl. And if anybody would find her diary, who will read it? Nobody would be interesting that what this young girl will write in her diary. But see that this diary of 13-year-old girl, it has turned out to be a masterpiece of literature also. Right? she was not regularly going to school, but she has written the diary. Okay, written the diary, but whatever she has written was absolutely true and ultimately without any, you can say, additions. Okay, to track someone. So this is the reason why this is a complete, you can say, account of the people who suffered a lot during Holocaust, okay, or during Second World War. So now in this diary, she has mentioned, she said that one day she was feeling quite depressed. She did not know how to pour out her feelings, and she also did not know whom to talk to. So finally, what happened that she found a piece of paper. She was giving an ejection to her feelings onto the paper. She started writing on the paper, and she was not in mood either to stay in the house or to go out of the house. So during that time when she has written her feelings on the diary, she felt quite relaxed. Okay. So then she has come to know that paper has more patience than people. Why paper has more patience than people? Yes, you can disclose your secrets. You can confide in paper. Okay, people will not disclose your secrets to somebody else. Moreover, you can pour out all your worries, all your distress, and whatever you feel onto paper. But ultimately, paper would not reply back. Okay, whatever you say, it will absorb everything. Okay, it will assimilate everything that is written on it. So this is the reason why she said that paper has more patience than people. Okay, so she said this is how she has started writing a diary. But actually she said that anybody would never believe that in this entire world, which is full of people, she is the girl who is living alone. Why she is living alone? Because she said that it doesn't mean that I don't have a loving family. Of course, she said that I have a loving family. Okay, in the family she had a loving father, mother, as well as her 16-year-old sister Margot. But she among number of friends, she has number of friends, but in those friends she is never finding a true friend. Why she is not able to find a true friend? It is because of the reason she is not easily mixing up with the other people. Okay, and she is not finding a true friend whom she could confide in, whom she could believe. Okay, who could keep her secrets as well. So this is the reason why she thought on that day, she thought that her diary would be her best friend. So next afterwards, when she had started writing a diary, how she got that diary? Because she was living in hiding. Okay, there she's not going to the market. She does not have any access to go anywhere. So on her 13th birthday, her father, they were celebrating. They were making small celebrations, okay, in the family, but in a very secret manner. So on her 13th birthday, what has happened that her father has brought a diary and has gifted it to Anne. So Anne on that day, she thought that she would start writing a diary and would name her diary as Kitty. So what name was given to that diary? As Kitty. So before writing her diary, she has also given a small background of the family. What she has mentioned, what was the name of the father? Her name of the father was Edith Hollander Frank. Okay, Edith Hollander Frank. Sorry, my mother was Edith Hollander Frank, and her father, no name was mentioned here. Okay, so her father was 36 years of age, and her mother was, until her father was 36 years of age, he did not get married. He got married only at the age of 36 years when her mother was 25 years of age. So during that time when they got married, after the marriage, they had two daughters. The first one is Margot and the another one is Anne Frank. Okay, so from her mother's name, she has derived that Otto Frank. Otto, father is Otto Frank, right? So next, afterwards, her father has gone in 1923. Her father has gone to Holland, and where in Holland he was setting up his business. So her mother has also gone along with her, and ultimately her sister, she went in December, and she was living in Frankfurt only, right? So then when her father, he has shifted to Holland, so she has also gone along with her father in February to Holland. Okay, so then afterwards the family was living together. So how she started her schooling? She started her schooling in Montessori Nursery School. So till here in this school, she has studied till class 6. So the headmistress What was the name of the headmistress of the school? Mrs. Cupress. Okay. She has developed a very affectionate, deep relationship with Mrs. also. When she was leaving the school, then they both had tears in their eyes while she was leaving the school. Okay. So then she has mentioned few people of his life who are important to her. Okay. So she has made a special mention of Mrs. Cupress also. Then afterwards, she has also made a special mention of her grandmother with whom she was so attached. She said that she was so attached with her grandmother that she used to spend long hours with her. But in 1941, her grandmother fell ill. And in 1942, she was operated and died after being operated. So after that, when her birthday falls, she did not celebrate her birthday. And what she did, she lit a candle in front of her grandmother's portrait, remembering her. So she has given a special, you can say, short account of her family before writing a diary. Okay. So then afterwards, only one diary entry from the whole, you can say, a novel is being taken here in your chapter. And here she has started with dearest Kitty. Who is Kitty here? Huh? Her diary. Okay. To whom she is calling Kitty. Okay. So the diary entry is of 20 June 1942. So she is explaining the day when they were awaiting their results. All the students in the class, they were discussing the results. They think that they were discussing with each other that who will get to the next form and who will not be able to go to the next form. Okay. And finally, they were betting each other also that whichever the boys will definitely pass to the next form and whosoever will be left behind. But they thought that teachers are the most unpredictable creatures on earth. So for herself, she was feeling that she is very well doing in all the subjects, but she is not doing well in mathematics because the mathematics, she has almost nine teachers in the school. Seven were women and two were men. And out of them, one was Mr. Keezing. Seven men, two women. And out of them was Mr. Keezing, who was her mathematics teacher. Okay. So her mathematics teacher, what she called him? Old Foggy. Old Foggy, why she has called her? Because she thought that the teacher is not getting, you can say, mixed up with the children. And moreover, he's a bit out old fashioned. Okay. So she was thinking. But ultimately, one day what happened as Anne Frank, she's talking a lot in the class. So what happened, Mr. Keezing, who was not able to tolerate this, he has told her to write down an essay on chatterbox. What is the meaning of chatterbox? The person who talks a lot. So he has told the girl to write an essay on chatterbox. So after finishing her work at home, when she was packing her school, she has put a slip onto the back so that she could remember that she has to write down an essay. So her eyesight caught that slip, and finally she started writing an essay. Okay. So she thought that like any other child, she would end up in big spaces in between the words in order to finish it. But she said that I did not want to finish it in this manner. Actually, I wanted to prove my point that this is the right of the child to speak, and she couldn't help speaking in the class. And moreover, how she has justified her trait of speaking. What she said that she has inherited this trait from her mother, because her mother also speaks a lot. So this is the reason why she is speaking. Then afterwards, the next day when she has submitted the essay, she tried to keep quiet for two periods. But again, when she spoke in the third period, then again, you can say Mr. Keezing, he again got irritated and told her to write an essay on an incorrigible chatterbox. So again, she has written the essay and fulfilled the condition so that she could be quiet in the class. But finally, when for the third time she was speaking again in the class, and Mr. you can say Keezing, he felt so annoyed that he has given her an essay to write on. Quack, 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 said Mistress Chatterbox. Okay. So finally, that was a great insult to Anne Frank also. So what she has written, so this time she thought that she would write it in the form of verse. How she would write down? She would write it in the form of verse. Okay, she would write it in the form of verse, in the form of poem. So who has helped her? Sen. Okay, her friend Sen, who was writing, who was good in writing poems, she offered to help her, and finally, with the help of her friend, she has written an essay in the form of a poem, in which she has mentioned the story of a duck and a swan. Okay, in which she has mentioned that they had three ducklings, and the father swan, what he has done, he has killed the three ducklings to death, bitten the three ducklings to death. Why? Because they were quacking a lot. So this is finally, actually Mr. Keating, he has took it in another manner, and how he has acted in the class. Yes, he laughed when he read this essay aloud in the class, and he has taken it in a light-hearted manner, and moreover, he has also read it in the other classes also, and by giving some personal comments, adding on some personal comments. So this is all about from Diary of Anne Frank. That means just one diary entry is there. Okay. So what were Anne's feelings about having a diary? What were Anne's feelings about having a diary? What she thought? Yes, she thought that keeping a diary, that anyone would not be interested in the musings of a 13-year-old girl. She thought that if anybody would ever found her diary, then no one would be interested in the thinking of this young girl. So this is the reason why she thought that people used to keep a diary in order to note down important dates or important things that happen in their life. But she thought that she would not keep this diary. Okay. But what she would do, she would note down the important dates and facts in her diary. Okay, what she would do, she would note important dates and facts in her diary. Okay, what does Anne Frank tell about his family before starting a diary? What she has told in her diary? What she has told in her diary? Yes, she has mentioned, she has given a brief account of her family. Okay, before writing a diary, she has given a brief account of her family, in which she has, what she has written, tell her to sit properly. Sit properly. So, then afterwards, what she has written, she has told about her father, mother. Okay, father's name was Otto Frank, and mother's name was Edith Olander Frank. Okay, so what was the age of father when they got married? 36 years. And what was the age of mother? 25 years. So afterwards, where her father has shifted? To Holland. Okay. And who accompanied him? Her mother. Her mother had accompanied him. And both the sisters, they were in Frankfurt along with grandmother. So first of all, who has gone to parents? Her sister. What was the name of her sister? Margot. What was the age of the sister when she started writing a diary? 16 years. Okay, so she went in December, and she afterwards she went to the parents, in February. Okay, right. And who else was in the family? Grandmother. So what kind of relationship Anne Frank was sharing with her grandmother? What kind of relationship she was sharing with her grandmother? She was sharing a relationship full of affection, deep love. Okay. So what happened in 1941? Her mother, grandmother fell ill. Her grandmother fell ill. And when she was operated in 1942, and what was the result of operation? That she died. And later on, how she celebrated her birthday? Okay, in front of. Okay, finally. Okay, by lighting a candle in front of her. So, this I will distribute afterwards, okay? It will be given to you. You have to fill it. I don't know. Your class in charge will better explain it to you, right? So I will give it to you afterwards. So next is describe about Anne's early education. What she has studied early? Yes. What write about Anne's early education? Where she studied till class 6? In Montessori nursery school. Okay. And who was the headmistress there? Mrs. Cupras. And what kind of relationship she has shared with Mrs. Cupras? Strong bond, attachment. There were tears in the eyes of both when they were departing. Right. Okay. If I will ask you to write or give some qualities of Anne's character? Young girl of 13. Okay, good writing skills. Imaginative in nature. This is the reason why she has written her diary. If she would not have been imaginative, she would not have thought that she would portray her feelings onto the page. Moreover, she is sensitive also, because she was distressed by the behavior of the people around her. This is the reason why she is not falling in deep friendship with anybody easily. This is the reason why she had number of friends, but she did not have even a fast friend to confide in. Okay. Then she was emotional also. Moreover, attached to her grandmother. Okay. This is the example we have read. Then sincerity towards work also. How you can say that she was sincere towards her work? Yes, when her Mr. Keesing has given her an essay to write for the first time, then what she has written? She has written an essay justifying her trait. It was not only for the sake of fulfilling the pages that she should write in her write an essay, but she was trying to justify why she is speaking in the class. Moreover, she is obedient also, because it is 3 times Mr. Keesing has told her to write an essay, and for the 3 times she tried her best to come up to his expectations, right? Okay, so she is a good girl, of course. Next, this chapter throws a light on student-teacher relationship and how for these values are necessary for learning. Yes, this chapter, of course, it throws a light upon student-teacher relationship, and it is very much important for the learning process, because until and unless there will be a healthy as well as understanding relationship between student and teacher, they will not, you can say, relate with each other. They won't be able to discuss the things with each other. So Mr. Keesing was not having healthy as well as developed relationship with Anne Frank, and it is because of this reason she is not trying to pay much attention in the class. She's talking, always talking in the class. But later on, when Mr. Keesing has given her an essay to write, then what she was doing, she was trying to justify herself. Okay. And although she was doing well in all the subjects, but for mathematics, she was not sure about herself. Why? Because she knew that Mr. Keesing would not give her good grades because she's not doing well in his subject. So it means that when she has developed good relationship, then she has developed interest in the subject also. So it means that the relationship between student and teacher is very much important to be a healthy one and understanding one. And this is very well explained in this chapter. Okay. Go from this side. Then why did Mr. Keesing call Anne Frank as incorrigible chatterbox? Why he has called her as incorrigible chatterbox? Because she is? Yes, because when for the first time she was given an essay to write on chatterbox, she was not able to cure her this habit, and she was speaking again in the class. She was speaking again in the class. She was talking a lot in the class, and being annoyed, Mr. Keesing has given her an essay to write on an incorrigible chatterbox. And again, she tried to justify it. Okay. And yes, he has given it to her to the third time. How did Anne finally stop Mr. Keesing from punishing her? by writing a poem, because where for the third time when Mr. Keating has given her an essay to write on quack 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 Mistress Chatterbox, then what she has written, she has written a poem which was in the, she has written an essay in the form of a poem, in which what she has written, she has clearly mentioned about the duck and a swan. Okay, then ultimately that they had three ducklings, and the father has bitten the three ducklings to death because they were quacking a lot, they were talking a lot, and this made Mr. Keating finally happy, and he has read it with much enjoyment. He has also read this poem in other classes by adding on his personal comments too, right? So this is how this stopped him. After that, he has never punished her. Okay, next is, do you agree, or Anne justified being a chatterbox? And justified being a chatterbox. She justified. What do you think? She has justified herself as a chatterbox. Why no? Why she has not justified herself as a chatterbox? She has justified herself as a chatterbox because in the very first essay, she has admitted that she is speaking a lot in the class. It is because of the reason. She has inherited the trait from her mother. This is the reason. Okay? Yes. Huh? Huh. She has not, but she has accepted it that she speaks a lot in the class. See, if I ask you what feelings pose, if I ask you, what you can say, what good qualities you have learned from character of Anne Frank. What you have learned? First is acceptance. She has accepted her mistake. It means that she has accepted that she speaks a lot. This is the reason why she admits. Wo to Mr. Keating the na, who is calling her a chatterbox. But that, what, for what reason he was calling, that was absolutely right. Because she speaks a lot in the class. Courageous she was, as Mr. Keating tried to play a joke on him, and she tried to play it on him, and ultimately she was successful. Okay, acceptance we have learned, and also sense of freedom. Okay, yes. Yes, right. So, this you know that paper has more patience than people. Okay, and moreover, what did Anne receive on her birthday? A diary, gift of a diary. Okay. So this is all about the discussion of this chapter, and I hope that with this everything is clear to you. Now if you have any doubt, you can ask me.